Hello everyone, this is Amjad and today we are talking about French Revolution. French Revolution, as the incident took place, we can go deeper and we can start up from the beginning where exactly France had started up and how, you know, we can go deeper into the history. But let's not go into that and let's go according to the conditions and situations that has been mentioned into the textbook. And I'll help you out in that case. So 14th of July 1789 in Paris, the people have gathered here in a large number, around 7,000 men and women have gathered just in front of the town hall to show their grievance, to show their anger, to show their protest. Why and what was the anger, what they did on that particular day with that anger and with that anguish is that, you know, they broke into all the government buildings. And they broke into all those government buildings, and one particularly what they did is that they entered and they broke the Fort of Bastille. The Fort of Bastille was completely demolished. This time when they broke it, actually there were only 7 prisoners inside. Though they knew that there are only 7 prisoners, despite that they broke it. What was the reason why? Though there was only 7 prisoners, what made them to break it? Because it's not the number of prisoners inside. It's the hatred that they had towards the Fort of Bastille. They hated it so much. They killed the commander of the Fort of the Bastille and they broke into it and they looted and they released all those prisoners. They looted the ammunition that was available. And moreover, after the building was demolished, all the stone fragments, what all was available, they looted it and they sold it even in the market for a better price. And some of them, they kept it for their, you know, for their remembrance or the kind of memorial kind of thing. Some they sold it in the market also, and it got sold out also. So what made people to break into the Fort of Bastille? Why they were so angry in them? So let's go into the history and just try to understand what made them to do so. So we need to start the story from the beginning, and particularly we will start with the coming of Louis XVI, when he came to the throne in the year 1774. So Louis XVI, who belongs to a Bourbon family, became the king in the year 1774, and the time when he became the king, he was just 20 years old. He was married to Marie Antoinette. Okay, and when this person became the king, he found the treasury was completely empty. It was empty because France was involved in unnecessary wars, and it involved into, you know, number of wars and a lot of expenses incurred due to it. When Louis XVI came to the throne, he also gave and extended the French help to those 13 colonies of America who were fighting for their independence with their common enemy called UK or England. Their common enemy was England. So when they were fighting with England, France extended their help in 13 colonies independence, and anyhow they got succeed in that, and because of which actually France was already in debts for about 1 billion livres. Because of the extension of the support to those 13 colonies, an additional 1 billion livres, it went into debts. And all those money lenders from now on started up charging a 10% of interest rate on that. So it was very difficult for Louis XVI to manage all the expenses of the administration. So, unable to understand what should be done in these circumstances, he thought of, you know, an idea that let us try to increase the taxes in the country. And for that, what he has to do, let us go into that. And before we go into that, let us see how was the society actually during that time in the 18th century. What was the society doing and how was it divided into? The French society in the 18th century was divided in 3 categories. Like, it was having a first estate, the second estate, and the third estate. The first estate consisted of the clergy, and the second estate consisted of nobility, and the third estate was categorized again into three different divisions. Like, there was a category of big businessmen, merchants, court officials and lawyers, who are supposed to be the upper upper class, or the upper or well-to-do people. There was another class called peasants and artisans, who was well off. And the third category within the third estate was of the small peasants, the landless laborers, and the servants. Now, these people, they suffered a lot, and they were the one who were downtrodden in the society. And here, almost all the entire population of France in the 18th century, it was consisting of nearly 90% of the peasants. 90% of the French population was consisting of the peasants, and the entire tax burden was levied on this third estate itself. The first estate and the second estate was the privileged class in the society, who were exempted of paying any kind of taxes. Now, different kinds of taxes were imposed on this, like even the churches too were involved in collecting the taxes from this section, and they were collecting a tax called tithes. A tax collected by the church is called as a tithes tax. And there was a direct tax which the people were supposed to pay to the administration, pay to the state government and to the government, that was called as a taille. And this tax was called as a direct tax, that is to be paid by the third estate to the administration. Apart from that, you know, there were many indirect taxes imposed on the people for the consumption of different commodities like tobacco and sugar and various other products that were used by the third estate. Now, under these circumstances, when the burden of taxes was already out there on the people, then when Louis XVI got the treasury empty, how is he going to work on this? How is he going to impose the new taxes and recover all the debts that the French government was going through? Will the people accept for this, or will the king can easily, you know, impose the taxes on this? Let us go ahead and see.